The opening segment features a series of speedbag forms called three-stage combinations. The purpose of this video is to provide you with a training program for mastering this intricate style. A format has been devised and presented here which systematically unravels any mystery about these techniques. You'll be provided with clear instruction and detailed visual support throughout this videotape. The speedbag has been used by professional boxers for decades as an important part of personal training. The average speedbag workout eventually becomes a stale routine. What you will soon discover is a new advanced program that goes beyond the typical workout. I call this system three-stage combinations because it's a mixture of three popular speedbag punching styles. We will examine all three styles, breaking them down separately and in detail.
In categories are the fast punch, the rhythm punch, and the simple punch. Roman numerals 1, 2, and 3 identify the type of punch and the bag's follow-up bounces.
We will begin with the standard routine most commonly used by boxers. The simple punch, consisting of one strike followed by three bounces. Strike, bounce one forward, bounce two rear, bounce three forward, bag centers, restrike. Let's look at a series of simple punches.
Simple punches have the longest range, building power and accuracy. The fast punch is composed of one strike followed by one bounce. Strike, bounce one forward, bag centers, restrike. Here's a sequence of fast punches. Fast punches have the shortest range, developing speed and snap. Later in part 3, the heavy bag is used to improve fast punches. I'll demonstrate my conditioning exercise, plus board breaks with the short jab. The rhythm punch is made up of two fast punches, followed by two bounces. Fast punches, break off, bounce one rear, bounce two forward, bag centers, restrike. In this sequence of rhythm punches, the break off and two bounces that follow are indicated by a dash. The rhythm punch can be expanded by adding more fast punches. Now here's a series of modified rhythm punches. rhythm punches improve pace and timing. The series of strikes demonstrated in part one have been carefully arranged so as to avoid overlap and repeat. For example, extended groups of right-left-right and right-right-left fall into the same pattern of strikes. You must perform each technique in part one correctly and with fluid movement in order to apply them in part two of this videotape. 1 hour workouts are recommended for making gains and building endurance. 3 minute rounds with 1 minute rest. In part two, we'll see the three stages come together. Here, the delivery of strikes is identical in each stage. Included with this tape, I've enclosed a printed combination sheet. It contains every combination set you'll see in this video, plus many more. Once you understand my method of notation, practice any set number as a speedbag routine. Speedbag forms are the newest concept for total variation in advanced training techniques. These combination sets have been created from the basic series in part one. Strikes in stages were selected and joined in a variety of ways. The sets appear as Roman numerals placed over right and left strikes. The Roman numerals identify the type of punch and their follow-up bounces. The Roman numeral 2 above the first group of strikes indicates a rhythm punch. The dash that follows represents the break-off and its two follow-up bounces. The second group of strikes is another rhythm punch. Strikes without a Roman numeral remain in their previous stage. Next, another break-off, followed by three simple punches indicated by the Roman numeral above them. Another group of simple punches. And finally, two fast punches identified by the Roman numeral 1. Let's see the combination in actual speed. Now again in slow motion. Each set that follows is numbered according to the printed combination sheet. If you have any difficulty understanding the structure of sets or the delivery of strikes, review the tape. After you've gained proficiency doing combination sets, apply them to your own standard routine. Here's a 1 minute round of the simple punch with set number 4i added at random intervals. By altering existing sets, new ones can be created. The first method is to add single or multiple strikes to the beginning or end of a set. Here are some examples. Add a right strike before the combination. Add a left and a right to the end of the combination. Add multiple strikes before and a single strike after the combination. Add multiple strikes before and after the combination. Another way of altering sets, in contrast to the previous method, is to change the internal structure of the set. Some examples. Change a right to a left. Add a strike. Delete a strike. Or change stages. Note, when a single fast punch ends the set, it's used specifically for stopping the bag in part 3. The new combination process applies to sets on your combination sheet. With this system, you can plan each speed bag form and experiment with your own arrangements. In this section, we're going to deal with broken rhythm and the heavy bag. Both of these elements play a vital role in sharpening boxing skills.
When a longer break-off from a series of strikes is allowed, the bag will swing out of time according to its own nature. During this period, the speed bag is producing broken rhythm. After the break-off, resume throwing punches whenever the bag centers. Broken rhythm is irregular rhythm. This occurs when your opponent begins to slow down. Your attack is launched in natural rhythm. Good counterattack ability requires a quick response with the proper strokes. The overall maneuver demands great precision. Speedbag broken rhythm develops a perceptual speed. This type of speed is the quickness of your eyes to see an opening as the opponent changes tempo. Combination sets ending in stage 1 are designed for broken rhythm or finishing the round. The amount of time between break-off and pickup of punches is at your discretion.
long break, short break, intermediate break.
Here's a 1 minute round of broken rhythm using techniques from parts 1 and 2. The speed bag can be stopped dead in its tracks. In this exercise, we're changing the fist angle and applying a stroke in double time. When the bag hits the forward platform, immediately push your fist forward and down slightly. Jam the bag against the platform. As the speed bag rebounds, it will center and freeze. This technique will adapt to all 3 stages. The objective during this training session is to sharpen the fast punch. Working multiple short jabs on the heavy bag builds concentrated power, speed, and snap. Rapid movements combined with the weight and resistance of the bag causing fatigue quickly. Hard work is necessary to increase your endurance. Accuracy is absolutely essential for these blows to be effective. This exercise is the key for smoother strokes and developing the explosive short-range punch. Bruce Lee realized the power contained in short distance strikes. I've decided to test this philosophy. Don't pull the punch. Follow through and generate power beyond the point of impact. The majority of techniques you've seen in this video require serious practice. This process is not intended to be mastered overnight. Attitude and discipline are important. The next phase in progressive speedbag training is to mix any number of combination sets. Compatible arrangements will produce a unique and distinctive beat.